on this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples.
I know how to live in humble circumstances.
And especially when we present ourselves for the anointing of the sick on this beautiful Sunday morning.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and the peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus be with you all.
And your spirit.
I brought the Pope along this morning. You have been here on a weekend?
Once.
Father Dick Robinson. He has joined the ranks of senior priests this year, and he has nothing to do now. And I'm still getting used to it. But it's nice coming and going and helping here and there. And as always, it's been wonderful helping out here and being with you. Today is kind of a unique and special day in that we are going to ask the Lord's blessing of healing and comfort for those who seek to be anointed today. And I'm sure our thoughts are also with Father Mike, that he too is continuing his process of healing. We ponder the kingdom of heaven as a wedding feast. God has great things prepared for those who are invited to the kingdom, but not all those invited accept the invitation. And some who accept are not prepared to enter. God's invitation is gracious and open to all, but we must respond. Lord Jesus, you are a sign of God's generosity. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you call us to respond to God's lavish invitation. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you help us to live in abundance and in need. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Let us pray. O God, may your grace at all times go before us and follow after, and make us always determined to carry out good works. And so we make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns in union with the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
A proclamation from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will provide for all peoples a feast of rich food and choice wines, juicy rich foods and pure choice wines. On this mountain, he will destroy the veil that veils all peoples, the web that is woven over all nations. He will destroy death forever. The Lord God will wipe away the tears from every face. The reproach of his people he will remove from the whole earth, for the Lord God has spoken. On that day it will be said, behold, our God to whom we look to save us, this is the Lord for whom we looked. Let us rejoice and be glad that he has come to save us. For the hand of the Lord will rest on this holy mountain. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
A proclamation from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, I know how to live in humble circumstances. I know also how to live with abundance. In every circumstance and in all things, I have learned the secret of being well fed and of going hungry, of living in abundance and of being in need. I can do all things in Him who strengthens me. Still, it was kind of you to share in my distress. My God will fully supply whatever you need in accord with His gracious riches in Christ Jesus. To our God and Father, glory forever and ever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
With you
and with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus, again in reply, spoke to the chief priests and elders of the people in parables, saying, "The kingdom of heaven may be likened to a king who gave a wedding feast for his son. He dispatched his servants to summon the invited guests to the feast, but they refused to come. A second time he sent out other servants, saying, 'Tell those invited, behold, I have prepared my banquet. My calves and fatted cattle are killed, and everything is ready. Come to the feast.' Some ignored the invitation and went away, one to his farm, another to his business. The rest laid hold of his servants, mistreated them, and killed them. The king was enraged and sent his troops, destroyed those murderers, and burned their city. Then he said to his servants, 'The feast is ready, but those who were invited were not worthy to come. Go out, therefore, into the main roads and invite to the feast anyone whom you find.' The servants went out into the streets and gathered all they found, the bad and the good alike, and the hall was filled with guests. But when the king came in to meet the guests, he saw a man there not dressed in a wedding garment. The king said to him, 'My friend, how is it that you came in here without a wedding garment?' But he was reduced to silence. Then the king said to the attendants, 'Bind his hands and feet, cast him out into the darkness outside, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth.' Many are invited, but few are chosen." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
We use the verbs to wish and to hope rather interchangeably. But generally, wishing has something more specific in mind. Like, I wish this beautiful fall weather would last throughout the winter. Or I wish that the Packers would decimate Miami this afternoon. Wouldn't that be a wonderful two wishes coming true? But hoping, on the other hand, is a little more open-ended. It's not so specified, because it's essentially a trust in a person that knows us and cares for us. And especially when we present ourselves for the anointing of the sick on this beautiful Sunday morning, the opening of our hands symbolizes a trust in the God. Yes, we would love to wish that whatever besets me could be healed, and why not? But the hoping says, Lord, you know far better than I just what I need, what we need. Be generous to us because I have come to know you and the bounty of the gracious gifts you have already bestowed upon us so very generously. What is the nature of this God of hope that the gospel presents today? As Matthew paints this picture, it is a justification for how Jesus could reach out to the most needy in his society. And the parable that he talked about said that he wasn't the first to do this. From ages past, the prophets came first and invited people to the kingdom of God, but they did not, the people did not listen. Then Jesus himself and his disciples extended it again to this very same people, and they rejected it. And then, like the story of the king, he said, I'm going out to all people. All are welcome now to my kingdom. But then that strange twist of the person at the wedding without the proper garment seems rather harsh. But again, the invitation to the banquet is the invitation to you and me to be members of the kingdom of God. But you and I know that we do not often measure up. And hence, the lack of the wedding garment is our way of saying, yes, we accepted the invitation, but we didn't do much about it. It's a little bit as if you or I would join a health club. Yes, we're members, but how many of us really go and use the advantages of the health club? So today, as we come before the Lord in this sacrament of the healing of the sick, we lay open our very lives before God and say, here we are. You have already bestowed upon us so much healing. You have come so close to us in inviting us to this kingdom. Help us when we have faltered, when we are weak, when we cannot see around the next corner. Be with us and strengthen us, O Lord, in our weakness, for we know that you care, support, sustain, and heal us. So Father Peter will join us again as he leads us now in the blessing of the oils.
Let us pray for our brothers and sisters, and for all those who devote themselves to caring for them. To the following, I'll ask your response, Lord, have mercy, after I say those words. Bless all those to be anointed, and fill them with new hope and strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Relieve their pain. Lord, have mercy. Free them from sin, and do not let them give way to temptation. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Sustain them with your power. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Assist all those who care for the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
In the moment of quiet prayer, I invite those who wish to raise hands over those who will be anointed. Give peace and health to all upon whom we lay our hands in your name. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
As we acknowledge this holy oil that we will use for the anointing, the response to these invocations is, Blessed be God who heals us in Christ. Blessed be God who heals us in Christ. Praise to you, God the Almighty Father. You sent your Son to live among us and to bring us salvation. Blessed be God who heals us in Christ. Praise to you, God the only begotten Son. You humbled yourself to share in our humanity and you heal our infirmities. Blessed be God who heals us in Christ. Praise to you, God, the Holy Spirit, the Consoler. Your unfailing power gives us strength in our bodily weakness. Blessed be God who heals us in Christ. O God of mercy, ease the sufferings and comfort the weakness of your servants whom the Church anoints with this holy oil. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
We will be coming to those to be anointed. So when we come before you, we will anoint each person first on the forehead with this prayer. Through this holy anointing, may the Lord in his love and mercy help you with the grace of the Holy Spirit. If you would then respond, Amen. And then if you would open your palms of your hands to be anointed with this prayer, may the Lord who frees you from sin and save you, and may the Lord who frees you from sin save you and raise you up. Again, respond, Amen, as we anoint the palms of your hands. And as a sign of our fidelity with our brothers and sisters, we ask that if you are near someone who is going to be anointed, feel free to place your hand on the shoulder of that person. So we continue then with this anointing. Father Dick will work through this half of the church, and I'll work through this half of the church. Lord our God, through this holy anointing, grant all your people comfort in their times of trial and suffering. When they are afraid, give them courage. When afflicted, give them patience. And when dejected, afford them hope. And when alone, assure them of the support of your holy people. We ask this through Christ our Lord. We rise then and offer our petitions and prayers to God.
Our response will be, Lord, show us the way. For a world without war, for dialogue instead of violence, we pray.
Lord, show us the way.
For a world without hunger, for bread for those who are hungry, and for generosity for those who have bread, we pray.
Lord, show us the way.
For a world without religious persecution, for believers who seek common ground, we pray.
Lord, show us the way.
For a world without prejudice, for tolerance, acceptance, delight in the diversity of humankind. We pray.
Lord, show us the way.
For a world without injustice, for integrity, honesty, and fairness in all our interactions with others, we pray.
Lord, show us the way.
For a world where our children are loved, nurtured, and precious, we pray.
Lord, show us the way.
For a world where refugees are welcomed and the homeless are sheltered, we pray.
Lord, show us the way.
For a world where the sick are healed, the sorrowing are comforted, the grieving are consoled. For Father Mike and all the prayers found in our Book of Intentions, we pray.
Lord, show us the way.
For a world where no one dies unmourned and unnoticed, for all those signed in our Book of Life, and especially Mark Rybicki and Ryan Driscoll, for whom this Eucharist is offered, we pray.
Lord, show us the way.
Lord God, we are grateful for your invitation to follow in the steps of your Son Jesus. May we not only accept the invitation, but be active and responsible stewards in your name. We pray this through Christ our Lord.
Our presentation song is On That Holy Mountain, found on page 16.
Of the land.
pray, my friends, that our gifts, bread and wine, and all that we offer today will be acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
For the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord God, accept the prayers of your faithful with the sacrificial offerings, that through these acts of prayer and devotion, we may pass over one day to the glory of heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just to give you thanks and to raise up a hymn of glory and praise to you, Lord God. For by the word of your Son's gospel, you have brought together one church from every people, tongue, and nation. And having filled her with life by the power of your Spirit, you never cease through her to gather the whole human race into one. And so manifesting the covenant of your love, she dispenses without ceasing the blessed hope of your kingdom and shines bright as the sign of your faithfulness, which in Christ Jesus you promised would last for eternity. So with all the power of heaven and earth, we worship you constantly on earth, while with all the church and with one voice we acclaim. God, you indeed are holy and to be glorified, for you love for you love the human race, and you always walk with us on the journey of life. Blessed indeed is your Son, present here when we are gathered by his love, and when as once for the disciples, so now for us, he opens the scriptures and breaks the bread. So merciful God, we ask that you would send forth your Holy Spirit and make holy these gifts of bread and wine, that they would become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, on the night of the Last Supper, Jesus took bread, said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his friends, saying, "Take this, all of you, eat of it. This is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when the supper was ended, he took the cup and gave you thanks, handing it to his friends, saying, "Take this, all of you, drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for all for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
The mystery of faith.
So Lord God, as we celebrate the memorial of Christ your Son, whom you led through his passion and death on the cross to the glory of the resurrection, and whom you have seated at your right hand, we proclaim the work of your love until he comes again, and we offer you the bread of life and the cup of blessing. Look with favor on this offering, in which we show forth the paschal sacrifice of Christ that has been handed on to us. Grant that by the power of the Spirit of your love, we may be counted now and until the day of eternity among the members of your Son, in whose body and blood we have communion. O God, renew your church by the light of the gospel. Strengthen the bond of unity between the faithful and the pastors of your people, together with Francis, our Pope, with our bishops, Jerome, Donald, Richard, and Rembert, with the whole order of bishops, that in a world torn by strife, your people may shine forth as a prophetic sign of unity and peace. Remember our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the peace of Christ and all the dead, whose faith you alone have known. Admit them to rejoice in the light of your face, and in the resurrection, give them the fullness of life.
Grant also to us, when our earthly pilgrimage is done, that we may come to an eternal dwelling place and live with you forever. There, in communion with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, with the apostles and all of the martyrs, and all of the saints, we shall praise and exalt you through Jesus Christ, your Son.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Let us pray with confidence, as Jesus the Lord taught us to pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Lord Jesus, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace. My peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but look on the faith of all your people. Grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you always.
With your spirit.
Share a sign of the Lord's peace. This is the Lamb of God, Jesus, the Lord, who brings healing and comfort. Happy are we who come to this table.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. We hold in prayer those who cannot be here but are waiting Eucharist at home. So those who are taking Eucharist to our homebound and are ill, won't you come forward? So we do send you forth from this community with our prayers for healing and comfort, and may you be enriched by what it is you do in service to your brothers and sisters. Go with our peace and blessing in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Lord God, we ask your majesty most humbly that as you feed us with the nourishment which comes from the most holy body and blood of your Son, we will become sharers of his divine nature and fully enjoy it one day in heaven. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Just a few announcements.
Announcements for this weekend. Attention all future mission trippers. We are going to Burn Baby Burn with the Light of Christ next summer. So show up and find out about the 2015 mission trip Monday night at St. Mary's for more information. Blood pressure screening is taking place in the Great Room after all masses this weekend and is a free service offered by our health ministers. Stop in if you're interested. Guests and visitors are invited to stop and back at the Welcome Center to ask questions or talk with a parish council member. See the bulletin, website, and Facebook for more information about activities here at St. James.
Thank you. What a joy to be here and to celebrate as we have. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
God's blessing to you all, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
And as we go forth, let us sing the City of God, found on page 38.